has an animated film been embraced by so many generations. It's an irresistible tale filled with delightfully lovable characters, adventure, excitement, and romance. It's the timeless Walt Disney classic, Lady and the Tramp, one of the greatest love stories ever told.
A Lady and the Tramp is really been a fun picture to make.
It all started as an original story by Walt Disney, but as Walt Disney explains...
Now in our studio, we don't write our story. We draw it.
First, the creators of Lady and the Tramp had to search for real-life models for their animated dog stars. This cocker spaniel became the pampered lady, while this adorable mutt was the model for Tramp. The first few test sketches of Tramp showed a dog that was a bit too serious, a guy with a sense of humor, but too big and clumsy for Lady. And then, of course, our irresistible hero.
Stop that racket,
original animators Frank Thomas and Ollie Johnson felt the real dogs made their jobs much easier.
These dogs all had personalities that were somewhat on the human side.
While most of the dogs in Lady and the Tramp were real characters, the romantic female lead was just what her name implied, a lady.
Well, he tried to make it feminine, and he tried to keep it soft and so it long, so it would slip and move like a feminine dog.
There she is, full-grown lady.
Oh, which way did he go? Which way did he go?
The bloodhound has very loose skin on it, and as animators, we thought, here, great possibilities there. You know, as he gets up with this ball down here, as he moves, it moves to different parts of his body, and starts to run it all over the bend ends, and the stuff, and the whole palace up here. We had a lot of good gags that way.
With the characters taking shape on the drawing board, Lady and the Tramp director Ed Penner and his team created storyboards as guides for the film.
Lady and the Tramp is a sort of a dog's idea of life. Dog meets dog loses dog, and of course dog gets dog.
Next, the movie's dialogue was recorded.
What he's trying to say, Lassie, is darling is expecting a wee bear.
Bear?
He means a baby, Miss Lady.
Oh, what's a baby?
Animators like Frank Thomas had to put those words in the characters' mouths.
What's a baby?
Lady and the Tramp has plenty of suspense and action. And here we see how the action was created.
The problem is, to get him out of his chest. We could get a good dramatic effect here by having part of his fight behind the barrels. And have shadows of the dog cats on the wall. Okay, let's run through this full sound effects.
Of course, no Disney film is complete without great music. And Lady and the Tramp is no exception. Here, the Mellow Man makes the music go to the dog. In Lady and the Tramp, the sets were painted. Then, 100 assistant animators inked the finished drawings onto animation cells, painting them in for the cameras and using nearly 4 tons of paint mixed in 100 shades and hues. Here's how one of the most memorable scenes in Lady and the Tramp came together.
Are you ready, dog?
For Disney animator Frank Thomas, one of the biggest challenges was to give his dogs a romantic starlit dinner, eating spaghetti. And studying real dogs did not help much.
No, dogs don't eat very pretty, really. They're slopping all over the place. And they could eat conventionally, but so that it's neat and tidy, and particularly ladies have to be very ladylike. I had studied people eating spaghetti more than I did the dogs, actually. And of course, the business of having one strand of spaghetti was folded together. But I went through the story sketches that were there. There was no getting the last meatball. All I had on my own couldn't get that done.
Story Story, characters, music, dialogue.